this is where all the projections are, the projectors I should say, and we're in screen three. So we're just going to set up the laptop now for the very last time, so we're ready to show the film. Hello everyone.
Hello.
What a turnout. Thank you all so much. I'm so proud right now. This is easily the most proudest piece of work that I've ever produced. And I think when we finished making this, I'm not sure if it was you or me who said that it wouldn't be great if we could actually put this out and actually show it in a cinema, rather than just kind of hitting the publish button on YouTube, because this is definitely something that deserves more, isn't it?
Yes.
It's something that definitely deserves to be seen at a big capacity. But just to give you a bit more of a context, because me and Mike, we filmed this documentary in June last year, where we'd spent the whole weekend, obviously, with James, who is easily the most inspirational person that I have ever met. And we just had such a great weekend with him. But this started out as a personal project. So every month I do a personal project, and when I saw the BBC documentary, as you'll hear in the intro of this video, I just really wanted to see him, and I really wanted to spend the weekend with James and teach him how to use his camera, because I just felt like it was something I needed to do. I just felt compelled, because it was just so inspirational when I met him. And when you watch it, the photography element is almost like a backdrop to, it's really just a backdrop, and it's more about the inspiration of James's attitude to life that Mike caught on camera. Mike, of course, filmed this and has been involved with the entire creative process of most of my projects in my career, including this one, which definitely stands out as being best work I've ever made.
Yeah. Again, I just want to sort of reiterate what Tommy said and just say like a massive thank you. It's pretty amazing seeing so many people here. You know, we didn't ever expect we'd get this big of a turnout.
No.
Yeah, like before Tommy approached me about making this documentary, I didn't know anything about James. And we were only spent 2 days with him, but after that you can easily tell he was just an absolutely incredible person. and I think for me, the most important thing was that he, no matter what happened to him, he would always smile. And I think that's how so many people remember him, really, you know. And I know that we both said that for ourselves, that's how we remember him.
Yeah.
So I think that's just an important thing to take away from the documentary, really. And I mean, other than that, just, yeah, enjoy.
So my name's James Dunn, I'm 23. I suffer from a rare genetic skin condition called recessive dystrophic epidermolysis bullosa.
Natural look. I think the angry slash psychotic one's much better.
So the first day I met Tommy was amazing. We spent a while getting to know each other and just
I'll just give you the one, then
I don't know.
My girlfriend said to do that.
Yeah.
Okay.
Is that okay? Yeah, it's great.
Cool.
I think I was more nervous than you were.
Lethal injection.
Oh no, it's the wrong one.
There's a lot more things to me apart from Evie, and that's what I like to talk about. I like to talk about how, you know, during my hardest times, through pain, through depression, the one thing that's kept me going is positivity and smiling and laughter. A great family helps always, but if you surround yourself by loving, happy people, and you remember, even if you're having a total rubbish day, that you always smile, you're not only going to help yourself and make yourself feel better, but you're going to help the person you smile to. So even if you're walking down the street in London one day and you see someone that looks a bit down, give them a smile. They might not say, you know, oh, that really cheered me up, but you know in your heart that that's going to have an impact on that person, and they're most likely going to remember that for the rest of their day, and it could help them. You know, they might have had a really bad time in work. Smile at them, make the day better. And smile for yourself too.
You've got your own softbox, your own light stand,
own
flash. It's the exact same kit that we use today, so you'll know how to use it, how to put it together.
Wow!
Same trigger, same flash, same softbox. You've got your own travel kit.
Thank you so much.
Thank you all so much for watching that. Shaking watching that the whole way through.
Thank you, Tommy.
Thank you. One thing I didn't mention at the start, and in case you weren't, it might not be clear, James did see this documentary. He saw an early draft that me and Mike sent to him, and he said it was epic, which is his favourite word, I think. Thanks ever so much for everyone for coming. Hugh from Deborah's, I'm going to ask to say a few words, if you wouldn't mind. Yeah, Hugh from Deborah, thank you.
I'll say a few words, and I deliberately didn't see the film until just now, like many of you, and really fantastic piece of work. Epidermolysis bullosa is rare, but it's not that rare. Over 5,000 people in the UK have it, 500,000 people worldwide, and it's a really cruel condition. It's cruel to the individual, it's cruel to the family, for obvious reasons. So we talked to James and his family about setting up FITB, and about looking at how we could explore how he could get to some of our events and perhaps use his photography and see where that might go. And we had some luck. You don't often get an A-list Hollywood celebrity going, yeah, come and take my photo. But Tom did. And the photograph that he took there was then shown the next day on Good Morning Britain. What we've achieved over the last 12 months is a huge increase in the awareness of this horrible condition. And as a charity, we are determined not only to support people with it and their families, but also, as you saw at the end of the film, to invest in research. Because it's only through that one day we will reach a cure. It's been remarkable for James, for his family. It's been remarkable for us at Deborah, and for that, Tommy, thank you very much. And for everyone else.
Uh, I just want to say a few thank yous. First of all, thank you to Phil, who's hiding around there. He's the manager of this cinema. Thanks ever so much, Phil, for letting us screen the film at an actual commercial cinema. Like, me and Mike were like, how cool is that, Mike? Our film's been shown in the cinema. Like, we can say that now. How cool is that? Like, we filmmakers dream of this moment. And so that's why we were, like, shaking all day, nervous all day. Probably more about the little talking versus actually playing the film. Let's give a hand for Michael Mowbray for filming this. There, and of course thank you to James's family. Thank you so much for accommodating me and Mike over that weekend and all the food and all that stuff.
Anytime, Tommy.
Brilliant, Mike, that's it. But yeah, as Hugh said, please donate fighteb.org.uk, and again I hope you enjoyed the film, and we'll see you on the next project. Thank you.
Amazing. First of all, James, what an inspirational lad, and certainly made a big difference to how I feel today, and will do for a long time, I'm sure. As for Tom, what a lovely thing to do. Tom is very, very inspirational himself, and he just gets up and does what he feels is right to do, and what he did for James was fantastic. And what he does with such a passion, and that just comes through in his work.
Incredible. I think Tommy showed me clips of that before when we were in the studio, but it's come on leaps and bounds since then. And Tommy's done a lot of work, we've done a lot of work together on music stuff, so to see him do some stuff which is a bit more, I don't know what the word is, meaningful, I guess, artsy, is very, very nice. Very good work from him, incredible work from Mike Mowbray as well, very, very enjoyable. It is a very emotional piece of work, and he's done very, very well to sort of capture that as well. Very impressed.
I've never heard of the condition before,
right,
so for me it was like a huge eye-opener. And the bit that stood out for me that was so hard to hold back the tears was the whole bit with James just talking to the camera about smiling at someone and making their day. And that, to me, it felt almost wrong that somebody going through so much has to remind people like us to do something so simple. And that was the bit for me that I was just like, got really choked up, because, I mean, how inspiring, coming from somebody who, from an outsider's point of view, you think would have nothing to smile at, and he's telling people like us who moan about very insignificant things in life just to remind us to smile and that things aren't so bad. So.
The effort and work by Tom, Mike and James as well is fantastic. It was emotional but positive as well, because every day we have a good day, a bad day, and I can just think of this message that James is saying. If I'm having a bad moment, I can just think of what he's saying, and that'll make me feel positive.
I just want to say that Mike and Tommy are an absolute diamond team, and they've done an incredible job on this whole project, and I'm very proud of them both, and they should be proud of each other.
Thanks ever so much for coming. We really appreciate it. This has been 11 months in the making. We filmed this 11 months ago, and we're finally now showing it in a proper commercial cinema. Like, how cool is that?
It's pretty much a dream come true.
It definitely is. So thanks again for Deborah. Please go and donate to Deborah, fighteb.org.uk, and please give generously to help the cause and to support people who have suffered like James did, but never out loud though. He
never complained ever while we were there. We forgot that he had EB, and it was just a great weekend, great banter as well.
Yeah.
Yes.
A lot of it seen, but a lot of it had to be kept off record.
Kept off record as well. He's seriously, the banter in that boy was incredible. Such an inspiration. So we hope you enjoyed the film.